introduction. Thank you very much. As I understand, I am invited in this excellent and challenging conference in my political capacity as the Greek finance minister during the operation of the so-called private sector involvement, the additional operation of the debt buyback some months later, and finally, the implicit operation of a huge official sector involvement, thanks to the excellent terms of the loan granted by the FSF in the era to the Hellenic Republic. I am indeed proud for this operation because this operation and the reconstruction of the Greek public debt give us now the possibility to demand the fair and right prediction about the future of the country during this very difficult period of negotiations, once again, about the review of the so-called third bailout Greek program, and also during this very challenging period about the necessary additional parametric changes to the Greek public debt. As you know, the operation of 2012 was the result of a very difficult and tough negotiations between the Greek government and our European partners, including the IMF. The IMF is a part of the so-called Troika and a very critical factor of this new institutional edifice, an official but very important one, because according to the willingness of the German government, the presence of the IMF is, until now, the most important guarantee, additional guarantee, against the European Commission and the gap of confidence because of the incapacity of the European Commission to predict the economic crisis, especially after the American crisis of Lehman Brothers and some years before the transfer of the crisis on the other side of the ocean. This is something very important because we need a real historical and political explanation about the presence of the IMF within the strong core of the Eurozone. This is something unusual, and it's very important to give a historical and political explanation about this new scheme, which against the official institutional architectural of the European edifice. From this point of view, the negotiation was indeed very tough, not between the Greek government and our institutional partners, but especially between the Greek government as the real owner of the bailout program and the real owner of the PSI, and the representatives of the international private sector, especially the IIF and the European banking system, because without a consensual approach about the need of a radical intervention in the Greek public debt, it was impossible to achieve this unique result of radical reconstruction of a public debt without disputes, without the repetition of the Argentinian example in the strong core of the Eurozone. This is something very, very important. From this point of view, the PSI and OSI operation was not only a financial one, but also a very important legal operation, because our first target was to protect the legal safety of the country before the international judicial system our own domestic judicial system, and also many arbitral panels and tribunals, because the legal system for the settlement of disputes from this point of view is a very big and open problem, open especially during this very important and challenging period of the open negotiations between the EU and the American administration on the so-called TTIP convention. This is something very important. As you know better than me, the result of the PSI operation had a theoretical, but not only theoretical, official basis, the debt sustainability analysis. I remember very well my last in private discussion with Charles Dallara, the main representative and negotiator from the part of the international private sector, during the last critical night in the Eurozone of 21st of February of 2012, just before the final decision about the scheme of the reconstruction of the Greek public debt. My own question was about the scientific character of the so-called debt sustainability analysis. If we have a solid, a coherent document, not only as a system of mathematical assumptions, but also as a system of coherent economic projections about the future of the Greek economy, not only as a financial system, but also as a real thing. The answer was very attractive, but also very dangerous and flexible, because the answer was a debt sustainability analysis is always something between science and art, because, as you know better than me, it's very difficult to organize a such fragile and complex system of economic assumptions about not only the numerator of this system, the famous primary surplus, as the main instrument to dealing with the debt and to change the projection of the debt and to achieve the famous sustainability of the debt, but the main issue is the denominator of this assumption, the growth rates, because without growth rates, it's absolutely impossible to achieve on a mathematical basis the target. But this famous debt sustainability analysis was just a projection of the face value of the Greek public debt in the future. On the other hand, the final result of this very ambitious and complex operation was a totally new size of the Greek public debt in terms of present value, because the parametric data, the parametric changes on the Greek public debt was friendly more than the official document of the Eurozone predicted. We have, as you know, now a duration of the maturities on the Greek public debt more than 17 years until 2099. We have average interest rates lower than 2.2%. We have a very friendly, a unique grace period. And finally, we have an annual servicing cost for the Greek public debt less as it concerns the interest, not the the maturities, less than 1.8% of the Greek GDP per year. This is the second best in the Eurozone, and from this point of view, we have the possibility to present and to calculate the real size of the Greek public debt in terms of present value, and to convince the market, the rating agencies, the academic community about the need to organize a totally new perception, new global perception about the real situation of the Greek public debt. But on the other hand, we are, politically speaking, before a vital and genetic contradiction, a contradiction in se, about the sustainability of the Greek public debt. From the very beginning, before the first bailout program, the problem of the sustainability was double: to fulfill the prerequisites of the internal rules of the IMF in order to achieve the involvement of the IMF on the first bailout program. From this point of view, the IMF needed the official verification by the Eurozone about the sustainability of the Greek public debt, because the sustainability of the debt was and is always the first precondition for the participation of the IMF on a bailout program. On the other hand, in order to achieve a second, more radical, more friendly intervention in the Greek public debt, in order to implement the initial commitments of the Eurozone on February 2012 about a second, more friendly and final intervention in terms of parametric changes after the achievement of the famous primary surplus, we need to present the argument that our public debt is not sustainable, because in case of the sustainability of the Greek public debt, it's not necessary to demand additional parametric changes. This is the vital contradiction about the viability of the Greek public debt. And this is a continuous global and domestic debate until now. The problem is that now the current Greek government is a government founded on the parliamentary groups of two ruling parties with a historical refusal about the importance and the magnitude of the operation of 2012. Because the last 4 years, the dominant position of the ruling parties now in Greece was that we need a new radical nominal intervention in the Greek public debt. The dominant public word, the rhetoric, was that it's absolutely vital to suspend the payments of interest rates, to suspend the service of the Greek public debt, and to organize an international, maybe a global conference, in order to achieve the historical target of the deletion in nominal basis of the Greek public debt. This position, this behavior, this refusal to accept the real size of the intervention of 2012 in the Greek public debt in terms of present value is a great obstacle in order to achieve the necessary political credibility domestically and globally about the need to implement now the existing commitments of the Eurozone about the last, the second and last intervention through parametric changes in the real size of the Greek public debt. But another more structural contradiction is that according to the decision of the European Council of July 2015, which the legal and political foundation of the so-called third memorandum, the third, the existing bailout program, the current Prime Minister of Greece accepted and consigned the conception of these parametric changes of the Greek public debt without any additional nominal haircut. This is something very important because it's absolutely counterproductive to reopen and to repeat this debate about the demand of a new nominal haircut like the PSI, because as you know better than me, a fundamental characteristic of the existing structure of the Greek public debt is the division between the big part of the 81% of the total debt held by the official sector and the second small part of just 19% of the debt held by the private sector worldwide. We talk about a totally unique case, about a totally unique stratification of a public debt, because we have a public debt held by our institutional partners, not by the IMF, because the IMF is, as you understand very well, the additional factor, very critical as expert, but not as a real lender, because the real lender of the Hellenic Republic is always the Eurozone under different legal forms. The other countries under the form of the Greek Loan Facility or the EFSF, and finally, within the frame of the third bailout program, the ESM. As you know better than me, because you are famous, the members of the famous community of accountability, according to the last official annual report presented by Mr. Eglin, the magnitude of the so-called implicit OSI of 2012 on the Greek public debt, only thanks to the friendly terms of the second loan granted by the EFSF, is equal to the 49% of the Greek GDP of 2013, indexed less or more 95 billion euros. The nominal haircut, thanks to the PSI and thanks to the additional debt buyback operation, the PSI Plus, was in March and in November 2012 106 billion euros. This is the biggest financial operation, historically speaking, worldwide. The problem is now to make a combination to demand the proper depiction of the Greek public debt in terms of present value and the implementation of the existing reconfirmed commitments of the Eurogroup about the necessary additional parametric changes in order to achieve a better present value for the Greek public debt, to grant an additional grace period, to stabilize the interest rates, and also to offer better maturities after the year 2059. With your permission, according to the last official statement made by the current finance minister before the parliament, the annual servicing cost for interest from now until 2059 is just 4.2 billion per annum. It is 1.8% of our GDP, according to a very moderate extrapolation of the nominal size of the GDP. If we must take into consideration the amortization, the biggest amortization from now, the biggest annual amortization from now until 2059 is 9.9 billion is just 4.4% of our GDP. The total annual servicing cost, including interest rates and amortization, is 1.8% plus 4.5%, less than 7% of our GDP. But this is necessary for the proper depiction. Our demand is double. We demand the proper depiction and the additional parametric changes. Why this is vital, substantial for Greece? Because only in the Greek case we have this big difference, big distance between the face value and the present value of the public debt. In all the other cases of public debt in the Eurozone, the distance between the face value and the present value is something between 2 and 6% of the GDP. In the case of Greece, the distance between the nominal value and the present value is more than 85% of the GDP. This is the unique case of the Greek debt, and our demand to present properly the real size of the Greek public debt is for us not a matter of transparency and accountability, but a matter of national sovereignty, a matter of national dignity, a matter of national perspective. And from this point of view, as member of the opposition now in the Greek Parliament, I am in the same line with the Greek Prime Minister and the Greek government in order to finalize this unique, comprehensive intervention in the Greek public debt. And to end my intervention with a specific reference in honor to Professor Scholl, who is a famous historian, especially of the French economic history. During the 19th century, Barrot, who was the prime minister of Louis Bonaparte, said a famous sentence, "La légalité nous tue." Now, in the Eurozone, la légalité kills us, because we are ready to accept a conventional approach about the presentation of the public debt, but this is something absolutely hostile and counterproductive, not only for the case of Greece, but also for the case of the Eurozone, because like after the deconstruction of the Ottoman Empire, like after the Second World War and before the Cold War, like after the fall of the so-called European dictatorships, once again, Greece, during this very long financial, but finally political and social crisis in Europe, is the main historical laboratory. Greece is the codification for everything. Greece is the epitome of the European crisis. And from this point of view, it's vital to clarify the situation about the real problem, about the real size of the Greek public debt, not in order to avoid the necessary additional intervention in terms of parametric changes and in terms of present value, but in order to present on a fair basis the situation. This is something very important also for our proudness and also for the self-perception of the Greek people, the Greek society, and also for the self-esteem of our society within a Eurozone with locked inequalities between the member states, because this is the main problem. The main problem and the main lessons from the economic and financial crisis is that we live within an institutional edifice, the European Union and especially the Eurozone, with huge locked inequalities concerning the cost of money, the cost of energy, but also the methodological assumptions about the presentation of the public debt, because another methodological choice concerning the present value or the net worth is more friendly and more fair for the Greek case. It's not my position to participate in this very important debate about the calculation of the present value of the debt. And from this point of view, I prefer to make reference in a German academic conventional calculation about the size of the present value of the debt. I understand very well the approach of my friend Paul Kasaryan. We have common concerns, the Greek, the Hellenic Republic and Paul Kasaryan. This is a common effort, but I prefer, for the needs of our discussion, to make reference to the late German academic calculation about the real size of the Greek public debt in terms of present value. As you know, the last paper presented by Schumacher and Ali calculated the Greek debt in terms of present value on the level of 98% of the GDP. Okay, I prefer to talk about the real net worth. I prefer to talk about a net present value on the level of 39% of the GDP. But okay, I'm ready to start the negotiation from the level of the German proposal. It's very important for us to talk about a public debt on the level of 98% of the GDP, because the international perception is that our debt is out of control on the level of 180% of the GDP. Thank you very much.